What's going on, everybody? Architecture here with a brand new series for you guys. Today, I want to start a series called The Inspiration. And with this series, what I want to do is I want to talk about what inspired, you know, certain video games and or, you know, trading card games or board games, things of that nature. So I want to talk about, you know, what in history or in television or any other media inspired the games we enjoy, we play. With this series, I plan on uploading it like once every 2 weeks. So I do have three series that I want to do. And I want them to alternate because I don't want to fill up the entire channel with just those series. Like on one Friday, you'll get this series, and next Friday, you get Where Is, another Friday, you get a different series. So, this is what I want to do with this series. And in the first inaugural episode for this series is The Divine Comedy. And for those who don't know what The Divine Comedy is, it's one of the greatest pieces of literature in human history. You probably hear it in a different name, Dante's Inferno. Dante's Inferno is a very, very popular video game, and it's a cult classic, and that game is based off the Divine Comedies. Dante is the writer of the poem, the Divine Comedies, Dante Alighieri. And that poem, the Divine Comedy, that piece of literature inspired a slew of content in media, not even just gaming, but even trading cards. In Yu-Gi-Oh, you have the Burning Abyss. This is a deck archetype that I play in real life, and I play also in a video game. What you're going to see on the screen right now is me playing Burning Abyss in the game. Also, like again, I have the cards in real life. And if you want to see my Burning Abyss deck, I'll even show that. But what Burning Abyss is just, you know, the Divine Comedy in Yu-Gi-Oh. You have, you know, your important cards, like, you know, Dante. You play three Dantes, and you can, and he has all these nice effects. You play all these different Burning Abyss cards that are named after demons from the Divine Comedies. You know, and one of the big boss monsters of the decks is Beatrice. Beatrice is the main female love interest in the Divine Comedies. You know, the person who Dante Alighieri was in love with. You have, you know, Virgil, who's like his guide. So, and even beyond that, in Dante's Inferno, the game starts off what you see in cinematic of Dante and trying to, you know, and you see Beatrice dying in the beginning of that game. So Beatrice, and that is his love interest. And Dante goes to hell to, you know, to rescue her soul and going through all these, this form of torment. Just, it goes beyond that too. One of the most popular and one of the most, you know, most beloved gaming franchises in gaming is also based off the Divine Comedy. That game being Devil May Cry. Devil May Cry is based off the Divine Comedy. You might try to, if just by me saying that, you know already who is based off who. Dante, Devil May Cry, is Dante in Divine Comedies. And they do some things to, like, you know, change things around when it comes to Devil May Cry. You know, Virgil, who is your guide, who's Dante's guide in the Divine Comedy, is Dante's brother in Devil May Cry. Beatrice in Divine Comedy is Trish in Devil May Cry. And even across other forms of media, you will see references to the Divine Comedy in anime. There's things like in Code Geass R2, one of the first episodes, you spot, you know, a reference to the Divine Comedy. In Fullmetal Alchemist, the main antagonist of Fullmetal Alchemist, you know, the Homunculi, are based off the Seven Deadly Sins, you know, with the exception of Father, of course. There was another one named Greed, but for the most part, they're all are a reference to things named in Purgatory, which is another book of the Divine Comedy. There's an anime called Cersei. I think that's how you pronounce it. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right. But across anime, across comic books, there's a comic book for Marvel. You know, Marvel right now is really big right now. And in Marvel, there was a comic book series called Nightcrawler's Inferno, which is, you know, Doctor Strange and the X-Men trying to save Nightcrawler from the Inferno, based off the Divine Comedies. So it goes across all of that. You know, Bayonetta contains multiple references to the Divine Comedies. Castlevania's Aria of Sorrow and Dawn of Sorrow have a lot of references to Dante's Inferno. The Descent 2, and I can keep going with all these. When it comes to these games, there's a lot of games across all of media that has references to Dante's to the Divine Comedy. Even Final Fantasy. Final Fantasies 4, 5, and 6 all have references to Divine Comedy. The Divine Comedy is a very large, very popular, I should say, not large, you know, piece of literature. You know, and across all forms of media, you will see something that references the Divine Comedies. You know, the Seven Deadly Sins, I mentioned before, when it comes to Fullmetal Alchemist, you know, that's a reference from the Divine Comedy. There's literally a show called The Seven Deadly Sins. So, you know, what I want to establish with this is that if you are someone who played any of these games or watched any of those mangas, or you're into Marvel and things like that, go get The Divine Comedy. Give it a read. It's one of the best pieces of literature known to man. I own The Divine Comedies. I've read The Divine Comedies. It's Dante Alighieri is an amazing poet. And us as gamers, we should broaden our horizon beyond just playing video games. We should want to read books, so we can see what the writers of those games that we play got the inspiration from. So with this series, I want to touch on that. I want to give everyone a quick glimpse into the mind of a writer. What was inspiration for this, inspiration for that. So I hope you guys enjoy this series. I plan on it being like a short, series, in terms of like it would be like maybe 4 to 6 minutes long videos, not the 10 minute, 15 minute videos. So like just like Warriors was not a long episode. It was like 2 minutes to 5 minutes, depending on what I was talking about. Same thing here. I don't want this to be a 10 minute video. So hope you all enjoy. Hope you all are looking forward to this series. Thank you all for watching. Hope you all enjoy. I'll catch you guys next time.